The 25th National Prayer Breakfast has been hosted by President Yoweri Museveni and the First Lady, Janet Kataha Museveni, at State House in Entebbe. The annual event is aimed at praying for the country, economy, families, as well as asking God for his protection. A number of choirs, led by the main choir composed of members of parliament, animated the day with melodious voices. The Court of Appeal judge, Justice Catherine Bamgemereire, delivered a testimony of the day, followed by intercession prayers by members of parliament and other dignitaries.
Save environment and still be happy. 31 years later, we still say, I do. When I think about my childhood, this is what the verse says. Perhaps I had a wicked childhood. Perhaps I had a miserable youth. But somewhere in my wicked, miserable past, there must have been a moment of truth. For here I am, standing here. And let me now use my own words, testifying of the goodness of the Lord.
As today, the eighth day, and eighth is symbolic in the heavenly powers, that we are gathered here at this national altar. Father my God, today we come in the power of our Lord to uproot, pull down, and destroy any force standing against our prayer at this altar. And we decree and declare that the power of God must take charge at this altar.
Archbishop Joseph Alexander from New York ministered the gathering with a powerful sermon, while Congressman Tim Walberg from Michigan delivered a keynote address and condemned immorality.
Do you pay so much attention to His Excellency, the great President of Uganda in the person of Museveni? Why do you hang around him? You made him a little lower than the angels. But you crown him with glory and honor. Psalm number 8.
This, for instance, is a thought of the World Bank, or the World Health Organization, or the United Nations, or sadly some in our administration in America who say you are wrong for standing for values that God created.
The First Lady of the Republic of Kenya, Rachel Ruto, graced the occasion and emphasized the power of prayers. She hailed Uganda's hospitality.
And when the church prayed, an angel of the Lord visited Peter in prison, and Peter was able to leave prison to say that when we pray, God answers, God sees, and miracles happen. We pray for peace, O Jehovah God. We are seeing even nations warring against one another. We ask for the peace of Jesus to be in every nation.
Janet Kataha Museveni, the First Lady, thanked God for guiding, protecting, and providing for the people of Uganda. She asked God to bless Uganda with economic independence to resist global forces of evil.
Thank you, Father, for the work of regional integration that is progressing, and a vision to see a united East Africa and eventually Africa. Lord, help us to not grow weary and in working towards this vision.
The National Prayer Breakfast was held under the theme, Fear Not, Repent and Serve the Lord. The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, emphasized the need to repent and reform. Tayewa went on to deliver a message from the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, who thanked God for blessing East Africa with a bid to host the 2027 Africa Cup of Nations.
I wish to congratulate Your Excellency, Mama Janet, Your Excellency the President, the First Lady Mama Janet, and counterpart heads of state of Kenya and Tanzania upon winning the bid for hosting the 2027 edition of the Africa Cup of Nations, AFCON. This historic event will create greater economic activity with tourists and football fans from all over the world converging in our region in 2027, but also strengthen the East African Federation.
President Museveni commended members of parliament for being persistent with the event. Museveni urged conveners to stick to the original values and purpose of the prayer breakfast.
So therefore, I want to congratulate the you, the organizer of the prayer breakfast, because I did it once, and I don't remember even how we did it, but you people, you copied it and you sustained it, because otherwise I would have forgotten about it.
Museveni condemned conflicts which are cropping up around the globe, saying they are motivated by selfishness and greed.
Catholics against Protestants, Christians against Muslims, tribes against one another. So I said, but what sort of Bernardini are these? What sort of religious people are these?
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.